The entropy condition can be derived along the following lines. Add a small amount of diffusion to the original problem. This yields a new problem with a small parameter. We can solve this new problem with the method of matched asymptotic expansions. The solution of our new problem then gives the requirement on the shock velocity. And as we saw before, this gives a second expression for the shock velocity in terms of saturations. Combining this then with the expression we got from Rankine-Hogonyi-Ho yields our shock saturation. We already saw this last part in the previous video, and in this video now we will focus on the missing link, the requirement on the shock velocity via the method of matched asymptotic expansions. So, what is the idea? Here we have our full problem with a small parameter epsilon and your water given in terms of the constant injection velocity times fractional flow in terms of SW, with injection condition 1 and initial condition conite water. And now we will use the method of matched asymptotic expansions. We will write SW as an outer solution plus an inner solution minus something where they match. Now the outer solution is defined on the whole interval. It will be some kind of a rarefaction wave. And the inner solution is focused around the shock. And then they match somewhere in between. You subtract where they match. And then the total profile gives you some rarefaction wave and then some smeared out shock onto your SWC. Now, how does that work? First, the outer solution. What do we do for the outer solution? We just set epsilon to 0, just kick this term out. And we start to solve starting from the injection saturation. And we get some rarefaction profile like this. Maybe followed by a constant state, that doesn't matter. Note the scale here, we are going to SW 0.9, something like that. But what is important, once we approach the shock, if we go in the limit eta to SW minus from the back, doesn't matter whether we have also a constant state after our rarefaction wave, the saturation will be our shock saturation. Okay, that's about the outer solution. We basically already did this one. Now the inner problem. For that we want to blow up the region around the shock. So we set xi equals x minus vs times t divided by epsilon. So where our v shock is over there is a parameter in the problem. So we're now co-moving with the shock. Our xi equals 0 corresponds to the shock, and because our epsilon is small, so we blow up this region around the shock. So if we send xi now to minus infinity, we arrive at this point here, where we arrive at the shock saturation. So what do we have? At xi equals 0, we have conate water, and if we send xi to minus infinity, we have to match with the outer solution with the shock saturation. Now, plug in this substitution. So what you get for the ddt, you get a minus vs over epsilon, so that's over here, times dd xi. For the dd x's, you get the 1 over epsilon. And you see that this epsilon over here is cancelled because the second derivative gives you 1 over epsilon squared. So you see, in the highest order, you have this equation over here. So now we have a second order equation for SW. But we can solve it, it's only an ODE. Summarized over here. So what kind of a solution do you get? You get to SWC at conate water, you go to shock saturation if you send xi to minus infinity, and you get something which goes smoothly from this SWC to your shock saturation. So your total solution will be the combination of this graph and that one, and mind the axis and mind the scales. This one goes from 0 to 6, and this is centered going from 5.5 to 6, something like that. So if you combine those two, you get a smooth profile connecting SWC smoothly to your injection saturation. So that's the idea of the method of matched asymptotic expansions. But how does it give us our condition. Well, that works as follows. So we had our problem over here. Just repeat it once again. When we solve it, we can integrate once from xi equals minus infinity to some xi in between. So if we integrate once with respect to xi, we get here minus phi times sw in. Here we get integrating once u injection times fw. Here one derivative is cancelled. And then we get the terms on the boundary. We started at minus infinity. So at minus infinity, we have a minus phi times sw shock for this boundary term. We have a u inject times fw at the shock situation for that term. And this derivative at minus infinity has to vanish because you saw the inner problem behaves like this, comes smoothly and then becoming very flat. So at minus infinity, this derivative vanishes. So that's how you can integrate your problem once. Well, in order to find this whole profile, you need to integrate once more. But that's not even needed in order to find our condition on the velocity. Because how can we find that one? First, we solve for the SWD xi. We get this expression over there. Of course, you can integrate that one, and then you have your saturation profile. But for the condition on the Vs, we can use a Taylor expansion for Fw minus Fw at the shock. So what is Fw around the shock? Well, Fw at the shock times the derivative at the shock times Sw minus Sw at the shock, plus higher order terms, of course, which we neglect. Plug this expansion in over there. And then we get the right-hand side over here. And you see they both have an Sw in minus Sw shock. So you can factor that one out, like this. And you have, from the first term, your u inject times the Fw dSw, and from your second term, minus phi times Vs. Now your inner solution, your saturation is always decreasing. So even if you do not know the solution, which you do not need for this argument, you know that this product has to be smaller or equal than zero. Now, you know, of course, that the Sw inner is smaller than Sw shock. So this quantity is negative. This one is also negative, so we have a minus here on the... we have here a minus sign, we have here a minus sign, so this must be a plus sign in order to satisfy the inequality here. So you know this quantity is bigger or equal than zero, and if you solve for Vs, your Vs smaller or equal than u inject over phi times dfw dsw at the shock. And that was the second equality we needed for our entropy condition.